in assessment. This is a very important part of the GRE, and this forms part of your first module in your GRE. The analytical writing assessment, as it is mentioned, has a very important feature. What do you mean by analysis? An analysis is one which, where a data is given to you, is evaluated, and the outcome is predicted based on the data and the importance of the data that is provided to you. So analysis, where an outcome is predicted, with the help of a given data. So this analysis is normally provided to us, and we need to analyze the given data and take the information which is important to us and then predict an outcome based on the data that is provided to us. Analytical writing assessment is the first module, and this contains two sessions. One is called the issue task, the other is called the argument task. We have one argument for this, where an issue task is the first part of your GRE examination. The moment you go for your GRE examination, you will provide that, you'll be able to understand that the first thing that appears on the screen is an issue task. Now, what do you mean by an issue? An issue is where there is a point of contention or where there's a point of dispute. Suppose I agree on a given point and there's another one who disagrees, or I disagree on a given issue point, then it becomes an issue. An issue is a bone of contention. A bone of contention is called an issue. So, a student here has the liberty to either agree with the topic or disagree with the topic, and if you can find it out, you will find out that the ETL also clearly provides that a person shall take a position. The student is required to take a position with regard to the issue topic and then explain with reasons and examples as to why he has to take that position. So it's very important that a student who encounters the issue topic on the first place should be able to explain his position and also enumerate the examples as to why he has to take that position. So, issue, you have 30 minutes to answer this, and you have this particular topic can be evaluated, and this is evaluated on a score of 6.0. So issue is the first part of your GRE, where you write your position, you explain your position, and you explain why you have to take that position, whether you agree or disagree, and you have to write it down, or rather type it down, and there's no word limit for an issue and argument topic. So it can be either 200 words, or 100 words, or 500 words, or 1,000 words, there's no word limit, but the most important point is how well you articulate your ideas, how well you present your ideas, and how beautifully you draft your presentation. That's what issue topic looks at. So this is evaluated on a scale of 6.0, and there are various parameters that are considered for evaluation of your issue on a scale of 6.0. But there's a time limit. The time limit is 30 minutes. Now when we talk about an issue, generally, as far as GRE is concerned, there are three types of issue topics being considered. What are they? So one is called the preference-based issue topic. What do you mean by preference-based issue topic? The topic that provides you an opportunity to take any position of you consider to be meritorious. So that's called an issue topic of preference-based. For example, let's take a small topic for example here. Formal education tends to restrain our minds and spirits rather than set them free. So if you see here, the topic is very clear. The formal education, what do you mean by a formal education? The basic education that is required for an individual to develop a career or nurture oneself is formal education. the formal education that tends to restrain our minds. It's very important that you understand the topic first, read the topic to understand what it states, and then the second point you need to consider when you go on the topic is to explain to yourself whether I'm going to support it or whether you disagree with it. What am I going to do? So what is that that I need to consider is, what do you mean by the topic? What are the examples that I can provide with this topic? And how do I approach this topic? Becomes very important. And every student should at least spend some 5 minutes in analyzing how he would go with the approach towards the topic. You are at liberty to either agree with the topic or disagree with the topic. There's nothing that tells you that you need to agree or you need to disagree. So it's up to you to take a stance and explain your stance. So how well you articulate becomes important, and what stance you take is not important yet. So the first 5 minutes can be spent by understanding how do I understand what the topic is, how do I comprehend the idea there, and what do I mean by formal education? Does it really restrain our minds and spirits? Spirits here is enthusiasm, rather than setting them free. Don't you think a person has the liberty to take a choice of his career? So formal education is a basis that allows an individual to take a step in the right direction to portray himself in the right path, in the right direction. So it all depends on how much I agree, how much I disagree, and what good examples can contribute towards this topic. This is a preference-based topic. I'm not restricted in taking a stance on this topic. So a preference-based topic is where you take a position on exploring this. I'll tell you later on as to how this is scored and how do we present this topic. For the time being, we look at the kinds of topics that we would encounter in a GRE examination. The second type of topic is called opinion-based topic. Now, what do you mean by opinion-based topic is, an opinion is only given that some people would agree with their opinion and some would disagree with the opinion. Now, you need to take a position as to which one do you prefer, the latter one or the former one. Let's take an example here. I'll give another topic with an example before we move further. Some people agree. That government funding for arts would help the arts to flourish while others agree that government funding of arts destroys the arts. Now, there are two topics here. Now, some people agree that funding is important. Funding would allow the arts to flourish, while others say destroys the very basics of the foundation of arts. So here I can choose one position and I can explain why I have chosen this position. When I'm talking about one position, I don't need to explain the other position. Automatically it implies that I have taken a position and I'm supporting my position here. So this is an opinion-based topic and where I would contribute my ideas in taking one of the positions out of the two given positions here. This is an opinion-based topic. The third one of the topics is called claim and reason. So let's look into the claim and reason of the third topic here. The third topic is claim and reason. Now, what do you mean by claim and a reason? A claim is a statement made by the author. A claim is a statement made by the author which he believes to be true. And the reason is a statement that he provides to justify his claim. Now, a student has the opportunity here to either support the claim and also to ensure if the reason justifies the claim. I have an option here. I can say that the claim is justifiable, but the reason is not justified. Or I can say both claim and reason looks very logical. Or I can say the claim is logical, the reason is logical. So here are the ammunition that I have and possess to provide more examples, to take a position as to whether I support with the other, I disagree with the other, is huge. Though this topic of claim and reason is seldom asked in the GRE examinations, you cannot rule out the possibility of its appearance in regular cases. So the claim and reason states that, but I'll give another topic of an example of claim and reason. Claim, as I said, the other statement. Now let's take an example. The surest way to understand the nation's culture and history is to read about its leaders and political figures. Now, that's a statement. That's what I believe. The best way to understand a nation's culture and the history of the culture is to read about the people who have strived for it, the people who have worked for it, and leaders and political figures who have manipulated the importance of the nation's culture. Now, when I talk about the reason here, my reason, as I said earlier, is a statement to justify my claim. Why am I talking about this? Because the way to understand a nation's culture from its citizens is the poorest way. So I mean to say here that if anybody wants to understand a country's history or a country's dominance or the way the country had been in the past, is to read about its leaders and political figures. That's the best way one can understand about the nation's country. And I'm also trying to justify myself by giving a reason saying that the way to understand a nation's culture from its citizens is the poorest way. So the welfare of its citizens, the way the citizens lived in that past, or the way they have enjoyed their lives or they have been depressed in their lives is not a sufficient indicator. But what is a sufficient indicator is the way the nation's culture is molded by the historical leaders in their own perspectives and the political figures who are able to manipulate the better part of their history. So this is called the claim and reason. Now I can support the claim, I can oppose the reason, or I can support the claim and say the reason is not adequate enough. I have a chance to either support it or oppose it. So the ammunition that I have, the amount of information that I can generate here is bound to tell me how I take the topic or how I accept the topic. What is very, very important as well as AWA's concern, and why is AWA so important as well as GRE's concern, is it provides an opportunity for the universities to understand how well you have been able to articulate your ideas. Now, if you question me as to how can the universities know about my presentation, your scores are an indicator. For example, as I said, your initial topic is on 6.0, so also is your argument topic on a scale of 6.0, and here again 30 minutes is provided to you. Now, if I'm getting a score of 3.0, which is considered to be average, is supposed to be good enough as far as universities are concerned. So if a student is able to get a score of 3.0 in issue and argument, which is called AWA, parts of AWA, we understand that the student has performed better. And if a student gets less than this score, most probably he would vacate all his chances of providing himself with an admission to a good school or university for his MS program. So it is understood that AWA becomes very, very important and integral part of the GRE, and it's evaluated in the sense that it makes one understand how good your presentation skills are, how creative you have been with your idea generation, because it's something like next tempore, where you are provided a topic and you discuss the topic and you present the topic with all your ideas. This is where the creativity comes to the fore. And please understand here that the examples that you provide in your AWA cannot be localized examples, cannot be examples which are narrow by nature. Those examples and the reasons should support your position. This is very, very important. And those examples which a reader of international standards can understand. The example should be of international example. For example, the Panama leaks, which has come out recently, which has been shaking the whole world, can be a brightest example for scandals and scams. So you should be able to provide such examples which a leader of international standards would be able to understand. So AWM becomes very important, an integral part, and please understand again that AWS course are not a part of your GRS course, and you will receive the AWS course 14 days after your examination through a scorecard which reflects on your verbal, your quant scores, and your AWS course. Thank you very much for your time being here.